to the country that there is activity, there is evidence of delivery. Are there things in the short term that can actually be done, or you just have to rely on a long-term strategy?
If you had asked me this question 3 years ago, and I was one of the first people to argue that Zimbabwe must adopt the South Africa rand and join the rand monetary area for a seven-year period or 10-year period. Why? Because South Africa accounts for Zimbabwe's exports in terms of 80% of all trade is with South Africa. So clearly you want a currency that is linked to your largest trading partner. But I don't think I want to argue that now. Things have moved on. I did actually quite a lot of scientific research on that issue. Things have moved on now. I think we're at a new juncture. So what I would argue now is that we have to remove the bond notes currency, which is becoming a surrogate, a Zimbabwe dollar, but without the macroeconomic credibility, no monetary policy credibility to support it. So that should be removed because it is bad money. And we know that in economics, bad money drives out good money. It's not surprising that even the US dollars are now in short supply because people are not banking those. They're keeping them under the mattress, to use a very simple phrase. So I would say immediate course of action is to remove the bond notes, let the US dollar again be the core currency of focus. But over time, we have to bring back the Zimbabwe domestic currency. That's what will deal with liquidity issues in a very big way. It's very successful.
Yeah, there's also...